Hello, hello. How's everybody doing today? Paula the makeup lady coming at ya. Gonna do a face today. Gonna do a basic face today. Cause I'm pressed for time and I just kind of feel, I don't know. I don't want to say I'm under the weather, but I just kind of feel blah today. All right. We're going to put some primer on my face. Hopefully my phone stays in the holder. My daughter-in-law accidentally broke my other phone holder. It was kind of funny, actually. So we're just going to go all over. With my primer. Okay. If you have any extra on your hands, it's good to put in your hair. Good stuff. And what primer does is it fills in all the pores and the lines on your face so that your makeup doesn't get in there and cake and make them appear larger. Good stuff. So we're going to let that dry a little bit. And I'm not really sure. I think I'm just going to do a little addiction palette number 5 today. Palette number 5 really doesn't get a lot of attention because people are afraid of it. And why would you be afraid of these colors? You've got a silver, a gold, a bronzy brown color. You get this beautiful red. This isn't pink. It's kind of like a red. And then you have the hot pink. You have purple. And you have the lighter pink, okay? And I don't know what my hair wants to do today. Just saying. I'm trying to let it grow out. Like my bangs, because I'd like to pin them back. So this is what it looks like for now, okay? All right, so first I'm going to do a little mineral touch foundation. It dries to a powder finish. We like to call it Photoshop in a bottle. And you gotta shake it up really good because it is mineral based, okay? Okay, okay. And oh, where is it at? I'm just gonna use my Real Techniques brush. We have a foundation brush similar to this. It's got a little divot in the middle for your foundation, your liquid foundation. Pretty similar. All kinds of good tools. And I'm going to add 3 big drops. That's all I'm going to add. A bottle of this goes a long, long way. And I'm feeling a little dull today. So I'm going to add a little bit of my Touch a la Mode Benevolent. And I just want kind of a glow on my face. So we're gonna go with it. And I need to look in the mirror. All right, and you just kind of go all over your face. Make sure you get up into your ears. I'm using the color Velour today. Sometimes I use taffeta, sometimes I use Velour. I already did my brows using our brow palette. I might have to touch them up. We'll see if I screw them up. Or not. But yeah, really, really good coverage. And it dries to powder finish. It's not greasy or oily. We have awesome foundations, people. And they're mineral based. They're animal friendly. Okay. And that's another reason why I like Unique, because they go by the European cosmetic standards, which is a lot stricter. I think, if I read correctly, this is made in Italy, okay? And they're a lot stricter about allowing chemicals in your beauty products. And that's why you're going to pay a little more, because it's real stuff and because it's made in Italy, all right? But I'd rather pay that little extra not to have a bunch of harmful chemicals on my face. Or have something that's cruel while being tested on animals. Okay? All right, so I have all of my foundation on. And as you can see, I have a faint glow about me. I have a little healthy glow about me, which is good. Okay? Healthy is good. Let's hope I remain healthy for a while now. I got over the crud about a couple weeks ago. Did not feel well at all. Okay, so we're going to do some Palette 5 fun. And trying to find a brush that I can just... I think I'm just going to use this little fluffy brush here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go into... the vintage, and that's like a, it looks pink, but it's not. It's a red, and it's a shimmer, okay? So I'm going to go into that, and I'm going to go all over my lid, and I'm going to come up into the brow bone, not all the way up to the brow bone, that bone right above your crease. And I'm just tapping. Once again, I'm using the colors from Palette 5. Look how beautiful that is. Love, love, love. Okay. And I'm just kind of blending it up and outward. Kind of softening it up above the lid area. Kind of just want to press it on the actual lid and then just kind of blend it above. But see how pretty that is? That's just one color, and that's all I'm going to use today. How beautiful is that? Wouldn't that be pretty for the holidays? And look how your blue eyes pop. All right. I'm going to tap it on over here. Just tap, tap, tap. These palettes are so fun to use, for real. And they're highly pigmented, so you're going to get a lot of use out of these. Little product. I just tapped into it one time. Look at that. Nice. Just simple. And who doesn't like simple, right? Okay. There you go. I think I'm going to actually add just a little bit more to this one, because the other one just looks a little shimmery. More shimmery. Okay. And don't overblend. I have a tendency of overblending. But see? Isn't that pretty? Okay. One color. That's all I'm going to do. Palette 5. one color. You do one color of the pink. Purple, same thing. Darker on the lid because you're patting it on. And then you're going to blend it up and out in the crease area. All these colors would work. Even this shimmery silver. Look at that. Or this gold. Pretty. That's all I'm going to do. Palette one. That's all I'm going to do. I am going to go up above with my highlight powder. And I'm going to clean off my brush. And I'm going to tap into that. This also has a mirror. It's pretty cool. Most of our things include a mirror. And I'm just going to put a little highlight up under the brow. Like so. Kind of soften it up. Nothing too glowy or sparkly. That's why I love this highlight. Because it's not real sparkly like some. And then I'm going to wake up my eyes a little bit. Stayed home. Went to bed early. Got my lavender oil diffusing in my diffuser. Slept like a baby. But I'm tired today for some reason. I think it's the weather. It's just, I don't know. Cold. It's probably it. All right. So that's all I'm going to do other than liner and mascara on my eyes. All right. So let's do, I don't know if I'm going to use cover up or not. I should, just so I can show you the awesome product. I'm using my, and it's supposed to come in the mail by tomorrow. I'll do an unboxing. My sculpting stick, my Duet sculpting stick. And I'm just going to add a little bit, not a lot. Because since I just added that one color, I don't have a lot of fallout under my eyes. And I'm just going to use our powder concealer brush just to kind of clean up and always bring it down like the shape of a triangle in front here. See how that's highlighting? Bring it up. Bring it out. So I've highlighted and I've concealed with my sculpting stick. That's how easy it is. And the other side is supposed to be used for contour. But as you all know, I broke it off into the cap because in a big hurry and I didn't put it all the way down. So I ordered another one. I have another one coming. All right. So in the meantime, I'm just going to use this generic one I got at Walmart. And you just go like halfway in the middle of your cheek and up. And then you want to add a little color up here and on the side of your face. Make sure when you blend this, you go up along the hairline so that it doesn't stay like this. So you don't have that big white gap. And if you want to contour your nose, come down the side like so. Okay. Underneath, or here, plump up your lower lip, make it look bigger with a shadow under there. Make sure you get your jawline. Okay, and then we want to darken this up under here a little too, because we want to hide any flabby or extra skin that you have underneath there. Okay, and we're going to blend it out once again with my powder concealer brush. This is so soft. Are you looking? Feels so good to put foundation on with this brush or to blend out your contour. Make sure you get it well blended. And up here, go up into your hairline. Make sure get it all blended. And what I'm doing is I'm adding interest. I'm darkening up here. The spots that don't naturally draw attention right away to your face. The lightness, your eyes are going to notice first. So you put that on the front of your face in the most appealing spots, I guess you could say. And then you darken up the spots that you either don't want to show or you want to add interest to. Like a hollow in the cheek that I don't have. This appears more prominent now because I darkened this up. I did a post earlier on my nails. My nails are really grody. I don't know what to do. I can't keep them long because my hands are in water all day long. I babysit my grandson in the mornings and then I manage a tavern and we wash a lot of glasses by hand. So they're in water, like a detergent water, pretty much all afternoon. So I just gave up on doing my nails. I just gave up. All right. See how that kind of makes your, the sides of your nose, they kind of disappear. And then the highlighted part kind of stands out more. That's what you want. And if you have a high forehead, large forehead, when you add contour, kind of darkens it and makes it appear not only more interesting to look at, but it kind of makes it appear shorter as well. Not as big. Okay, so I have that done. You can also do that with our bronzer. I have a new one of these coming also. You want to add a little sunshine, just add bronzer. And then I am going to brighten up under my eyes. I do this all the time with our, whoops, wrong one, our powder highlight. And because it's not so over the top, you can totally brighten up your eyes, see? I love this stuff. I use it on my eyes, I use it on my face. You can use it on your lips, over your lipstick. It just adds a little healthy glow. Okay. Then I'm going to pop just a little bit of color on my cheek. I'm just going to use a stippling brush and I'm just going to tap. This is our powdered blush. This is the color Scandalous. We have all different kinds of blush and you're going to get a mirror. Most everything in a compact has a mirror. So cool. Just on the apples of your cheeks is all you want. All right. And then I'm going to blend everything together using my Behold setting powder. It's translucent powder. And it just smooths everything out. And it's going to set your makeup because it's a powder. You can put it over your brows. Anywhere you want to set your makeup. See how nice and kind of a blurring effect. Kind of has a little Photoshop effect and helps with your flawless look. Okay. All right. So now let's do our apples. and I haven't used my pencil in a while. I think I'm going to have some fun. I think I'm going to use my navy blue pencil liner. This is Precarious. And I'm going to use that. Let me sharpen it just a little bit. I don't like a real sharp point on my pencil liner. Just that'll even do. Okay. So I'm going to start here in the corner. And I'm going to come in, and our pencil liners work really well. And I'm just going to use short strokes along the lash line. And I'm going to come in. Like so. Okay. Same thing over here. This is our navy blue. Kind of a cute look. I'm doing this on my phone, so I apologize for the faces that I'm making. Get down by your lash line. Okay. Like so. And then I'm just going to come down in the outer corner. This is the way I do my eyes. You can do your eyes any way you choose. And if you wanted to make your eyes even pop more, you could color the waterline with a white liner. That would be awesome too. See? That look nice. Easy peasy. So now I'm going to do my Epic Mascara. And of course, I can't put it on without getting some up above. If that ever happens, just take a spoolie and scratch it off, like so. Epic Mascara. I've said this time after time. Best mascara ever. Possibly the whole world. It's nice. Okay, and you can use this on fake lashes also. It is not waterproof, only we do have a waterproof. If you like that waterproof, we do have it. But if you're using fake lashes, I would suggest not using waterproof, because then you can gently clean your lashes off and reuse them. Okay, see? Nice. All right, let's see. And what do I want to do with my lips? I ordered some lipstick, and I ordered some new Splash liquid lipsticks, the new ones. I can't wait. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use my upscale Opulence lipstick. It's kind of a peachy color because I want my lips to appear full. And I've noticed if I use, isn't that a beautiful color? If I use a frosty color, like in a nude or a coral or a pink, just makes my lips appear larger. And a good thing to do, and anything that could get on your teeth ends up on your finger. Just make sure your fingers are clean. See? Pretty? Very nice. Very nice. I learned that trick watching another presenter. There's all kinds of little tricks you can learn from each other. Like soaking your mascara in very, very warm water for about 10 minutes before application. You're going to utilize and soften up everything inside the tube. It's not going to be clumpy. It's not going to get stiff in colder weather like it sometimes does. Good hack to use. Another good hack is to apply concealer to your lips before using a bright color. That way the color just pops and it will last longer. See? All right. So now we're going to seal the deal. I'm going to seal my brows. We're going to seal my eye makeup. We're going to seal my face. And it's going to last longer. Our setting spray is never sticky. It's a big bottle. This is my hand. It's a big bottle and it lasts forever. It comes out as a fine mist. All right. Make sure I got nothing on my teeth. Okay. So that's my Thursday look. And if you like what you see, make sure you go to Paula the Makeup Lady, my Facebook page, and follow me, like the page. You can also find me on YouTube. I have YouTube videos. Subscribe to my channel, Paula the Makeup Lady. And you can also follow me on Pinterest. All right, have a good Thursday and see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.